If you've played Minecraft before, you know it's a game about survival. The gameplay involves pitting you against various hostilities and elements in an attempt to make you die, essentially. And that's kind of the whole genre of open world games. However, I fail to see how zombies, skeletons, and other fictional antagonists relate to the common man and the common man's struggles. What we really need to make Minecraft the exemplar of the survival genre of games is to incorporate our own innate psychological flaws. In other words, we are connecting Minecraft to our brains. On a more serious note, this video is kind of tying up the loose end of this brain-computer interface ordeal. If you have seen the previous video on this channel about 2 years ago, I urge you to disregard what is said in that video, mostly because the content is fairly outdated. So here is a new beginning to that. So as I said before, we're using this Emotiv device to be able to convert your emotions into things that occur in the game. For example, if you are very stressed, we want to amplify that stress by making all the enemy mobs much faster. Now, we're also implementing things to help you just for fun, like if you're excited, you will run faster, for example. Things that make sense. So I'm going to go through the requirements. First of all, we are using, of course, Emotiv. I'm using here the Emotiv Insight. It's the most affordable option because this is Minecraft. We don't need anything crazy. And because we're creating a Minecraft plugin, we'll have to use the language known for Minecraft, Java. And that's just a sacrifice we'll have to make to appease the general public. Furthermore, just some other little things. I'm using Maven to handle the dependencies and builds, and Spigot to do the plugin development. So let's take a look at the actual code. Here we have the Minecraft side of the plugin. As you can see here, I'm kind of working backwards in this. We're taking the data that's fetched from the Emotiv and just converting it into, like, as I said, speed changes with excitement, monster movement speed changes with stress. In total, there's all these metrics. You got engagement, excitement, etc. You can read the rest here. And I'm not using all of them, but theoretically we could, for example, make it so that when your interest is high, you immediately die or something. That was just an example. That wouldn't make sense in this context. So let's look at the Emotiv side. Now, full disclaimer, I don't really know anything about brains or neurology, at least not beyond the basic background knowledge needed for a non-neurologist, but I don't really need to because Emotiv provides an API. API stands for Application Program Interface. And what it means in this situation is that they do all the hard work and I just take the data from it and profit. So here is the Emotiv side of it. As you can see, it's just a WebSocket client. I could go through how to do this, but this would just be a WebSocket client tutorial and that's not very interesting. I'm committing a bit of an atrocity because I'm using a trust manager that just trusts any certificate. Now, since this is a secure WebSocket client, it requires a certificate to be able to go through from the server to the client. The server is the thing that is provided by Emotiv itself, and I'm just kind of trusting everything. I'm hypothesizing that the average Minecraft user doesn't really have a brain-computer interface, and even if they did, it wouldn't be really practical. So I'm just expecting that this would never go into production, which is why I'm doing this. Now, a bit about Emotiv. Emotiv seems to be marketed towards researchers and artists, evident by the fact that their API server installer only comes in Mac and Windows. Furthermore, on the actual hardware of the headset, putting your head into this kind of feels like putting your head into a garbage chute, and the battery life is overall pretty underwhelming. Nonetheless, it works. So I'm going to put this on. I'm actually going to have to take the headphones off, because putting this on while wearing headphones is like putting your head into a garbage chute while wearing headphones. So hopefully the microphone can still pick up my voice, and I'm going to put it on and get hair out of the way. So there's that. The headset connects to the computer via Bluetooth. I have this USB Bluetooth dongle. Voila. So now that that's done, we now have the server running here, and we can then launch the client. The client is, of course, within the plugin. So I built it with Maven, and it's already pre-built, so I don't have to go through that. So I just have to run the server. This is the Minecraft server now. So we have a server that has a client, and the client is in the server of Minecraft. And then now we're going to open the Minecraft client. So we got, it's easy to get lost, but just if you just think about it, it's all good. There we go. And so you can see on the bottom left, we got all the metrics. I am very low excitement, and so I am relatively slow. Although interest and engagement are pretty high. I think engagement increases attack damage of the monsters. So that's actually not good. So this is some pretty fun gameplay. Now clearly there's a problem here, and it's that I'm not very excited, so we're having some very slow gameplay. Luckily, there's a little trick up my sleeve. It's consuming caffeine, and hopefully that will increase my excitement, at least even marginally. Well, let's have another go. Excitement is still only 19%. I guess I am just... I guess it's just not working very well. Oh, it's getting a bit higher. So the caffeine strategy didn't work very well. So not wanting to leave this video empty-handed, I'm going to attempt one more thing. One thing I could do is engage in anxiety-inducing or painful things, but I am not a masochist, and so I'll just be playing very exciting music, and maybe that will solve the issue. So even though I said that wearing headphones with the headset is very uncomfortable, I'll be doing it anyway in the name of science. So, there we go. Give myself creative mode. 1000. And then let's just get a bunch of creeper eggs. And we'll go over here. Oh, we already have some creepers here, so we'll put down some more. All right. Now we have a horde of creepers there. I'm going to play the anxiety-inducing music. And set myself to survival. So let's see if we can speedrun not dying. Oh god, oh god. Oh, I keep clicking out. Oh. All right. Huh. I guess they're gone. Oh, there they are. Hello. As long as I keep my stress down and my excitement up, I should be able to outrun them no matter what. Let's see if I can run through them. Notice as my excitement increases, my speed increases. Oh, I was too confident there.
Well, that was that. I was able to get my excitement high enough to demonstrate to you the super speed, but I wasn't able to make myself stressed enough, or at least not higher than 50 or so percent. Maybe if there was more dire situations, I would be able to make it more stressed. If you ever end up in a stressful life or death situation, consider installing the plugin and giving it a go. Anyway,